Honestly, Vanguard's been a little bit of a rough start, and the whole community has gone basically berserk over the game's launch. So with that, I'm not sure on what content I'm going to make further on from this video, but all I'm going to say is that if this video does well, then I'm probably going to stick to cobble glitches because these videos seem to do well, and I'm just going to probably stick to whatever does well here on the channel. But with that, if you guys want to level up your XP or tube aggression during Season 6, then this video should help you out tremendously. And without further ado, let's hop right into the video. Enjoy. Alright, so for our first glitch, come toward the spawn area, and you want to come toward this truck. Now, once you're here, come toward the middle of the truck where this tire is, and from there, push a little bit back and jump mantle forward, and if done correctly, you should mantle on top of this truck, but you should fall through it. Once here, all the zombies in the game should pile up right in front of you, and you can easily get your headshots done whilst in this glitch. The only thing you must worry about is the abomination zombie type. This can hit you, but for that, I recommend having the Ring of Fire field upgrade to quickly go through the elite, and if you want to exit this spot, look behind you and move forward, and you should be able to exit via doing that method. Alright, so heading into glitch 2, come to the Anytown West area and look toward this poster. You want to make sure you have the PhD perk at least tier 4 or above, and with that, you want to slide forward toward this poster, and midway through your slide, you want to pause your game like so. You can now unpause your game, and if done correctly, you should breach through the wall like I do here, and you want to get a far enough breach so that you go through the wall and into this vending machine. When you are here, the zombies will pile up right in front of you, and if you do need ammo, you can grab this by zombie powers, which you can drop right in front of you, and you can pick these up. Just like the last glitch, the abomination zombie type can hit you, but for that, I recommend having the Ring of Fire, and if you do want to exit this spot, have the Aether Shroud tier 3 or above, and Aether Shroud forward. For glitch 3, come toward the Anytown West area and come toward this roof. Top. All you want to do is come toward the edge of this roof, and you want to look toward where I do here, and if done correctly, if you have gone far enough toward the side I have here, the zombies should all pile up right in front. But with that, you can go through cameras pretty easily whilst using this spot. Do note, the elite zombie types can hit you, but again, have the Ring of Fire field upgrade, and you should be able to go through them as soon as possible. I recommend having the Crystal Axe 1 weapon to go through rounds fast whilst in this glitch. Heading into our next glitch, come to the same area as the previous glitch was, and you want to have the PhD perk at least tier 4 or above. You now want to come toward this wall and slide toward it, and you want to pause midway through your slide and unpause. If you have done this correctly, you should push through the wall like I did here, and do note, if you don't get this on your first attempt, I recommend giving it a few attempts as it can be a little bit difficult, but giving it a few attempts can get you a high chance of getting the glitch eventually. When you do get here, come around the area I did, as there may be a death barrier taking damage off you, but when you go around this little area, zombies should all pile up right in front of you, making them easy to kill. Again, the abomination zombie type can hit you, however, having a high powered weapon can easily make it so he's not that much of a threat. If you would like to exit this bot, have the Aether Shroud tier 3 or above, and with that, Aether Shroud forward. So heading into our last glitch here on the map for second for the 1.26 patch, come toward the Story Zone 5 rooftops, and you want to look toward this zombie spawn point, and with that, slide toward this wall, and midway through your slide, pause your game and unpause. If you have done this correctly, eventually you should go through the wall like I did here, and from there, all of these zombies should pile up exactly where you just entered the glitch from. I recommend now having a weapon with the Shadow Blast ammo mod or the Raygun Wonder Weapon, because these zombies will all pile up and you can't really see them. They can only come from this area below these zombie spawn points, so for that, just keep on shooting zombies from this area, and like that, you can easily go through rounds using this glitch. If you would like to exit this specific glitch, but have the Aether Shroud tier 4 or above, and with that, simply Aether Shroud forward like I do here. But with that, that's basically all of the current working 1.26 after patch Cold War Forsaken glitches. Just before ending the video, I just want to go through the future of this channel content wise, and I'm probably going to stick to some Cold War type of videos, so I may do this kind of like once a week with an all glitches, but I'm not sure if I'm going to be continuing this over time. I might go to Vanguard a little bit, but there will be a mix of Vanguard and Cold War content on the channel. If you do have any games you want me to check out, leave a comment down below, because I'd love to go through your guys' recommendations, because at the moment, I'm not truly sure what to actually upload next on the channel, so please post what you want, and I'm down to just look at some other stuff. But with that, that's pretty much it for the video today. If you guys have enjoyed this video, or if you have found it useful, then please do consider smashing the like button, as it does help the video spread out to more viewers on the platform. And till next time, goodbye.